Hey, one last thing. Here's my final headline. Report: climate change is here and getting worse. The National Climate Assessment was released on Tuesday and presented analysis suggesting that the perils of carbon emissions are not in the distant future, but far more immediate than initially feared. And no corner of the country is being spared. Said the report, summers are longer and hotter, and extended periods of unusual heat last longer than any living American has ever experienced. Winters are generally shorter and warmer. Rain comes in heavier downpours. Now, one day after the release, former Utah governor, Republican John Huntsman, published an op-ed in the New York Times imploring his party to no longer ignore the realities of climate change. Huntsman noted something curious, that while evidence of climate change mounts, Republican disbelief is rising. He pointed out that according to a Pew Research poll, whereas in 2006, 59% of Republicans said there was solid evidence of rising temperatures on Earth, that number has now decreased to 50%. Huntsman also recounted how when the issue was raised at a North Carolina congressional debate last month, well, here's the brief clip.
Is climate change a fact? Mr. Harris.
No.
Ms. Grant.
No.
Mr. Brandon.
No, God can close the climate.
Mr. Tillis.
No.
Huntsman noted that all the Republican candidates chuckled about a question about climate change as if they'd been asked about their belief in the tooth fairy. What drives that disbelief? Well, first consider this. Last spring, Pew Research noted something else, that while only 40% of Americans said that global climate change was a major threat to their country, more than 50% of Canadians, Australians, French, and Germans gave that answer. More than 60% of Italians and Spaniards, and more than 70% of Japanese. What accounts for the difference in concern? As I tweeted this week, fewer Americans worry about climate change than Canadians, Aussies, French, or Germans. Hey, do they have talk radio there? In other words, this all-important matter of global survival has been relegated to the trash heap of our partisan divide, fueled not by scientific debate, but by bluster generated by men with microphones. How do we change things? Here's a terrific suggestion that came from a letter to the editor of the New York Times. Reacting to Governor Huntsman's anecdote about the North Carolina debate where the candidates chuckled about climate change, Mr. Douglas Shepard wrote that a better question need be asked of candidates, namely, on what climate studies or data is your belief based? What a great idea. But I'd go a step better. Let's apply that same standard to those in the media who weigh in. So you remember that headline? Report, climate change is here and getting worse? Here's what I would have written. Show me the science on the tooth fairy.